Keying is not only for blue screen and green screen. Welcome to a short tutorial where I'm using the Luma Keyer in Fusion for a simple sky replacement. This tutorial is part of a longer training course, but you can do it standalone and also download the footage without any sign up. So, when you're ready, let's get started. I'm starting my first keying composition with these two videos. I have the camels on the right, which have a monotone gray-white sky, and on the left I want to use this sky video, and as you can imagine, just replace the sky to give this a bit more interesting background. So my camels here are pretty dark, the background is pretty uniform, so I hope that I can separate the camels from the background by using the difference in contrast luminosity here. And for this we can use the Luma Keyer. So let me immediately put it in. I select the camels and add the Luma Keyer tool. And now I will look at the original on the left and the key on the right. And you see already that there's some transparency coming in here. Although the camels are getting transparent, the sky is not, so I need to invert it. Now when I'm analyzing keys, of course you can look against the original picture, but another thing which I tend to do is look at the full key on one side and only at the alpha channel on the other side. That's often a good way to analyze. And in the alpha channel I see that my camels are not perfectly white and the background is not perfectly black. And of course black means fully transparent and white means fully opaque. So what can I do here? I have a few sliders which we can now discuss one by one. Before we get to it, let's look at the first one, the channel. I said I'm using the Luma Keyer, and originally this keyer used to do only luminance based matte extraction, matte separation, but now this keyer, even though it's still called Luma Keyer, actually has multiple channels here to choose from. So I can decide to create my key based on luminance, low-high separation, or I can go into an individual color channel like blue, green, red, etc. Or even use saturation, for example. And one thing which I can do is I can just experiment here. Luma Keyer, this was my first idea, because when I looked at the original picture I thought, okay, this is a good contrast, very bright background, less bright foreground, but actually what might be even better is one of the color channels. And red of course doesn't work because the camels themselves are red, but if you look at the blue channel you get a pretty good separation. And the reason is of course that the sky is not really blue, but white still contains a pretty good blue portion, whereas the camels are reddish and don't contain any significant blue portion. So the blue channel, if you see at the immediate result, gives a better separation between foreground and background than the luminance channel. So since we figured that out, we can as well continue with the blue channel. Now we have these sliders which give us the range of values which are considered for the key. So this is a hard range. So if I increase the lower end, you see that I'm getting out of these gray areas. So basically I'm editing a grayscale picture here. And yeah, putting the lower and upper edge. And you can see if I go to extremes here, I can, if I go so far, I can make the foreground completely white, the background completely black. This is not always desirable when keying, but let's start with this. Now let's look at what we got so far. Of course this is not perfect, especially around the boundaries we will see problems like this, but it's a pretty good start. And if I go through the timeline, I don't see any holes in the key. I don't see any major artifacts coming in the background. The only thing which might not work out of the box is these soft boundaries of the camel. After widening this a little bit, we can look at contrast and gamma. And both is again, contrast, we are talking about the contrast in the alpha channel. So I can increase the contrast and thereby immediately get a harder separation, get the light gray areas out of the way. The same with the gamma. I can sometimes even, in a bit finer way, increase the lightness or darkness of this black and white picture, again with the goal to get a good separation. Let's go a little bit back, because we already found a relatively good start here. So I might even leave this like this. And now let's have a look at the edges. So when we look at the back of the camel and compare this, let me go back to the color view, compare this with the original view, original picture on the right, key on the left, you see that even in the original, of course, edges are always a bit soft, just because of the camera resolution and the point that each contrast is, of course, mapped to pixels at the end, and depending on your resolution, your edges are more or less soft in an original picture. And the edges in the key, your goal should be that the edges in the key are similarly soft as in the original picture. So what you sometimes see in beginner videos or in some not so well keyed web videos, sometimes you see that people don't have a good key. Let's say the key is not, the edge is not very good, that they have a very hard edge and then just blur it too much to cover any edge problems that you have. This is of course not the goal of the blur. The goal is not to cover up keying problems. For this we should really work more on our key, work on the matte and contrast, for example, or use different keying technologies and so on. And really get our key as good as it can get, and then the blur, we should only use it to mimic the softness of the original key in the keyed picture. So let me get back to the kind of image I had here. So let's say we have a relatively hard edge. We have adjusted the key maybe quite strongly. And then I look at the edge and I see that, let's compare similar part of the screen, and I see that this part looks softer than this. And in this case, the hard key, which maybe keys away too much, is for at least for the back of the camel not so much of a problem, because we are just keying here. So if we are cutting off a little bit on an animal, you might not see it. So even if my key is a bit too aggressive, maybe I will not notice that I'm cutting away too much here. But what I do notice in this case is the softness left and right, and with a careful tiny little bit of blur, I can adjust this and make sure I have similar transparent values here. Now, depending on how aggressive I was here on the back, it's relatively simple. But here on the front, I might, or around, especially around the eyelashes, this might be quite tricky. Well, it's not as bad as I thought. But yeah, if you're very critical, then this area, probably our setting here, is already a bit too aggressive. I see there is a slight hole here. Let's go again once to the alpha channel. I think for the sake of demonstrating, I'm adjusting my values here too quickly. Let's widen this again a little bit. And yeah, maybe we work a little bit with contrast and gamma in order to remove any holes we have in the foreground. And let me look again. Now the blur might already be a bit too much. Oh, maybe not. Okay, and let's pipe it over the background and go to the color view. Okay, let's look at it in the larger view, and I think this looks not so bad for a web video or so, that this might already pass through. Of course, there are more techniques that we can apply, and there are more adjustments that you can do. You can work with other keyers as well in this scenario, besides the Luma keyer. And there's more to the edge treatment that we can do, and we will discuss more about it throughout this course segment. But for a quick start into keying, I'm already quite happy with this result. So let's accept this as our first pass with the Luma keyer, and next we will look into the real keying technology for blue screen and green screen and so on, and we will start with the Ultra keyer in the next video. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial. If you're interested in the full course, head over to my course page, and I hope to see you there.